Okay, so continuing our series on the Kuttim, Ezra Parak Dalet Pasuk Vav in the Malbim. You got it? Uvimeir Tachshasta Kasav Bishlam. So the this is the beginning. Actually, Pasuk Zayin. Sorry, this is the beginning of the period. Of the, the beginning of the letter, right? Which they wrote in the days of Artaxasta. The Pasuk Vav is talking about Machus HaChashverosh, that wrote a Sitna. That Sitna is not to build a base on Mikdash, is not specified. In the days of Artaxasta, they wrote something else. Now, Rashi says, Artaxasta, who Koresh Melch Paras. It is the same king, Koresh, okay? And this is getting confusing because it says Min Osi Shul Koresh, the gematria of Koresh Olam Min Osi Os Da Yavesh, and V'chein Shani Maseches Roshana Who Koresh Who Da Yavesh Who Artach Shasta. He was all three, Koresh, Hashem Shemel Kosher Haya, like Kosher Koresh. But Artashasta Shem Malchus, Artaxerxes was the name of the king of Persia. We say Lo Matzasi Taryovish Artaxasta. The Chol Malchus Kula Nikris Artaxasta. Okay, so Kosav Bishlam Kosav Michtav Advarim Shalom Mitirdas Shtav Oil Shem Adam Hu Mitzari Yehuda Bin Yamin. So one of the enemies of Bin Yamin and Yehuda Mitzradas Tav El wrote a letter to Artaxasta. Okay, let's read the pasuk actually inside. Can't hurt. Mitzradas Tav El Ushar Kenovo Sov, which evidently according to Rashi means Chaveiro Sov Esil Sov. The rest of his chevre Artaxasta Melech Haparos Uksav Anishtavon. And what it said in the letter, Kosav Aramis, was written in Aramaic, Umasurgam Aramis. I guess it was written in Aramaic letters and written in the language of Aramaic. Okay, let's go back to the Malbim. Malbim says, Umeh Tavshas Kosav Shlam Osochru Aleim Yotzim Lofer Bin Yonk Moshin Vair. Osochru Aleim Yotzim Lofer Bin Yonk Moshin Vair. Then they wrote, they hired counselors to undermine the building. And there are several opinions about the kings of Persia and their names. Artaxasta ze behechrech hu koresh, kmo shpirash Rashi. It's got to be Artaxasta's koresh. The obi may koresh nishpas habinyan, because the time koresh the building ceased. Tzor kmo shishem Artaxasta hu yoshem kovel machi poros. They often say Artaxasta is the honorific given name given to the kings of Persia. Like Paro to Mitzrayim, Avimelech to Plishtim. Uman Mashat Artaxasta Hushem Acher, that's not correct. So Marshalish Basabinyan, you have to say that the building did not cease Arachar Mos Koresh until after Koresh died. Artaxasta Zemelech Achar Koresh. Artaxasta is when the kings came after Koresh. Kibacholov and Tsarechlomar, you have to say name, and she abinyan ishbas, yudalit shanim. The construction was halted for 14 years. Shem shnei shvuim shekasim Daniel. Those are the 2 weeks alluded to in Daniel, in his vision of Fipe Rushi, according to my interpretation. Neitam shenavolavar and yonaba, atzia hakdamachas. Before we come to explain the following matter, I'm going to give you an introduction. Kipolemod, which is a wonderful or astonishing introduction. Since Koresh himself gave the law to build, and he said Hashem commanded him to build the house. How in a short amount of time did he renege on this law and cancel the building? Especially since we know since in the laws of Persian media, any writing which is written in the name of the king, even the king cannot renege on it. Kamvur b'inyan Daniel. That's why Daniel was thrown to the lion's den, because once he was true of the king, Dariovish, I believe, was tricked into throwing him in. He had to be thrown in. B'inyan Achashverosh, shaloyachol batel ksav ados. Haman's ksav ados. Av shenichta betolos, even though it was written by mistake, which by me preferish Megillas Esther, like we explained in our commentary on Megillas Esther. Zoshenius. Furthermore, Shehen Kosvu, they wrote Shayudim Bonim, that the Jews were building Umabatsrim Chomos Yushalayim, and were fortifying the walls of Yushalayim. Mizeya Sheker Gomor, because the walls were only fortified, as we saw by Nehemiah much later on. Shelo Bonu Rakas Abais, we only built the Beis Hamikdash. Vachom Alonim Ne'ari Me'ar Tachshas Shara Salam Zevashus. He gave the special dispensation. Being a bias, how could possibly be any revolution, a revolt, by the being a construction of the base of Mikdash? If they have no fortified city, what? Yeah, which would take shelter. The base of them ate from heaven. The base of me is built of wood and stone. We know that they built the original base of Mikdash when they came back to Eretz Yisrael out of wood and stone. This is done deliberately. That should easily be burned down if they rebelled. Kamoshi Spire, Basim, and Bov. So how did he turn his ears to matters of law, which were outright lies? How did the enemies say outright lies? So based on this, we can see an illumination of these pesukim. In truth, there was in this great treachery. By day shocha mamon, and by the monetary bribe, shenos nutzare Yehuda, which is given by the enemies of the Jewish people, sochru yoatzim b'tzlech mirma b'yodam. They hired counselors, and they were lobbyists, I guess you call them today, and their treachery was successful. Kizos yodu, this they knew, shelvatos bin abayis udova sheyavshar. That to cancel the building of the Beis HaMikdash was something which was impossible. Kvi kukei poras hamadai, based on the laws of poras hamadai, shekosav, asher nichta b'shem ha-melech, because something which is in the name of the king, ain't lashiv, you cannot renege on. V'gam shlo yechlu al shina hazeh, they also can't say snitching, this is probably a better word than that, on this. There is no concern of revolt in the building of the Beis HaMikdash. Because the walls of Yerushalayim are broken. And also to write these lies to the king that the Jews transgress his command. Then instead of building the Beis HaMikdash, Hashem Bonim Chunasa Ir. Hisyaru, to say this, that they were building the walls of the city instead of the walls of Beis HaMikdash, they're afraid. Paini Vodala Melech HaShashekar Tibru. They're afraid lest it become known to the king that they were speaking lies. V'chai V'lo Shom HaMelech, and their heads will be liable to roll. V'hoi Atzlasim Bov and Zeh. So this is their counsel. Ki Ba'asher Malchus Paros Ha'isam Malchus Gedol Rechava. Because Persia was a very wide and broad kingdom, but it was only an empire. There were many nations among it, which spoke each one according to its own language. The law was, anyone wanted to write to the king, he write in his own language, in his own alphabet. Much closer, like it says in Megillah Esther, we also call Ish so wherever they so, everybody would be master of his own house and speaking in his own language. In each medina, there would be two officers reporting from the king, the Kabbalah is Mikhtavin to receive the letters, Shikvakasubi Loshan and Medina, which are written in the language of the local state, Asherheim Abba, where they were all dwelling, Latikosam Loshan Wilksab Paros Lushacham Lamelk. And they, those officials, would then translate them and send them on to the king. And the answer to the king would come in Persian. Now, to these two officials who would copy it, they would translate it into the language of the country. And give the copied answer to the writers. There were two officials in Syria, Rachum Baal Tam, I guess its name is coming up, who Matik min Lashon Lashon, he would copy from language to language. Rachum Baal Tam would translate, and Shimshi would then also change the alphabet from the local alphabet to the Persian alphabet. So in Syria, their writing and their talking was in Aramaic. He writes there, the name was Bishlam, was one name. The Rashi said Bishlam was a name. So Bishlam was like the piece of. Yeah, so Rashi says, Kasim Ichtava Dvarim Shalom. He says there's one writer whose name was Rashi said there was one writer whose name was Misridas Tav El, and he wrote a letter of peace. The Malvim says there are three writers: Bishlam, Mitras Tav El, and Shakan Osav, which he agrees is Hainu Chaverav Siosav, his friends and his acquaintances. Kasa Aratach Shasta Melch Paras. They wrote to Artaxerxes, the king of Persia, Ksav Nishtavon, Hainu, Parsi. They wrote in Persian. Okay? That's with Who was in charge of that? Ksav Nishtavon, it was that you had to change and make sure that it was correct. They edited and gave it to the king. They gave this letter, which was written to the king, that they should change it into Persian. Okay, so let's see that in the next Pesukim slide. Ruchum Beltat Beltaim. Okay, not Rachum Baltam. Ruchum Beltaim. Bishimshi Safra Ksobi Gar Chada Yushalayim. They wrote one letter Yushalayim Latach Shasta Malka Kinema. Kinema, Rashi says, as we shall say, as we shall see. So it says, Mahabim Rachum Rachum Bazachum Beltaim. They were the copiers, and they were trustworthy to the king. They're not going to make a forgery in their work. They were treacherous in their copying over. The writers, who were Bishlam and the other guys, they wrote about the Beis HaMikdash. Ruchum and Shimshi, they translated and they wrote V'etikoyim ha'sak sabasit ha'bin in Yerushalayim and in Yerushalayim itself. Zeh shekosu igra chad Yerushalayim shen kosu sheyudim bonim umadim v'atzim Yerushalayim. They wrote that the Jews are building and fortifying Jerusalem. Chol zeh aya zeh uv'chol zeh aya zeh ba'ofen. And this is all the way that if we found out, the king found out that they were speaking falsehood. Shalovan is Chumash Yishalim Rakas Bayit. They only built the walls Yishalim around the house. Based on Mikdash. Lo Yichol Manish. Lo Asa Kosim. Lo Asa Matikim. They couldn't punish anybody. Not the writers. And not the copyists. Kamoshi is Barab Apostle Kosvi Beis. Then Kosul Artach Shas. The Malka Kanema. Kashen Omar. It was the laws of the king Shishnei Asarim Shishmar Latik. Hey, Kosu Shmon Barosh HaMichtov. They wrote their letter, their names at the head of the letter. Kim Yodomi Bakish HaMelech. Because they're going to be responsible for the king. Im Yanase Eza Ziv Mim Rabatako. If there's any forgery or the treachery in the copy. Kar Kosu Shmosa Kosu Yabakshim. And then they wrote the names of the writers and the supplicants. Kim Yodomi Bakash. From them, it's also going to be demanded retribution because it's a sheker b'gufa mikhtav. Besides being able to punish them, they're writing falsely. Also, the king should know who the supplicants were. And this was written on the letter. Like we saw today on the letter. It came from everybody who was on the other side of the river. This is something which is not a simple matter. It has to do with all the nations of the world. And therefore they wrote the following. Pasuk Tes. Edayin Rachuchum Be'el Tam. B'shimsi Safra, Adayin means Rashi says then. Then Rechum Baltaim, B'shimsi Safra, V'shar K'navason, and all the other groups, Dinoyeya, V'afar Satakia, Tarpalaya, Afor Soye, Arkavoye, Bavlaya, Shushan Choye, Dehavoye, Elmaya. Okay, this is going to be the next puzzle too. Ushora Maya, these are all nations, and the other nations. Tihaglei, who were put under the ghost by Asnapar Rabba, who was Sancheirv, Asnapar the Great. Vyaki Raya, and the great and precious. And he put all these nations in the cities of Shomron, Ushar Avre Nahare, and the rest of the other side of the Jordan River, I guess. Ukeenes as well. So all these people, Dino Parshegani Agarto, they all spread out this letter. The Shlachol Elohi, which is sent to them, Al Artashasta, Malka. On to Arshachtas the king, Avdoich and Nash Avarnahaya Ke'enes. Your slaves, the people of Arnahaya and Ke'enes. Okay, so let's see the Ma'abim on this. You with me here? Okay, so Ma'abim says, Edin Rachum Beltam Mushim Shamsar, Shem Matikim. Maskimim el dvar bakasha. They also agree with the request. B'shacharim bakshim and all the other supplicants. V'esheim zosheim. B'shacharim bakshim zos. Heim dinoi v'afar stachaye. Kulam shemos emos. These are all names of nations. Shoshiv sancheirib arei shamron. Who sancheir put into the city of Shomron. K'mosh b'yish Rashi. Shushnechaya, Bnei Shushan, Du El Maya, Shkankan Bnei Elam, Hashem Medina. Shushan is a city, Elam is a country. Koshkas Shushan be Hashem Elam Medina. Sharamos Hashem Glasamcher Melech Rav Gadol. This is a translation, right? And the other nations which were put in the ghost by Samcher of the great and mighty king. But Shiva Samba raised Shomron and put them in the cities of Shomron. The Yeser Moshe Shemer Bnei Avan Shiknas and all these other nations. There are many nations, not just the people who originally wrote the letter, right? There are many, many nations which are involved in this now, right? It's also, you can say that Mishlam Mitzvadas comes to Ganke Chasumim, Mikam Orim, that they gathered several signatories from several cities, Lashosusol Makesh Alzeb Mishlam, to get their permission to write this on their names. That's more. Now, from here, Pasagah begins the content of the king, the letter itself. So this is the copy of Sheshochu after Shasta Melech Avdach Anshe Ivanor Kananas. Because Katsu Lo Chashukulam in the letter itself, they didn't write all the names of the nations. They just sort of rock Haschola, just the beginning, Avdach Vagomer Ad Ivanor Ukananas. Shkena Dakim Shalach Bo Bechobam Kol Shemos. They didn't write the letters all the time, only once at the beginning. Raksab Haschola Vasof Ubaem Tzakosam Mila Shlam or Gmir, Kwash Anakasvim Bechule or Vegomer. So when it says the word Gmir, Mishlam, I guess it comes up later in this thing. Kwash Tere Pasuk Yuzayim Simon Yuzayim Yuzayim, Kamlo Etik Mila Shlam or Gmir, Lekatser Hadvarim. Okay, so eventually it's going to use that word as if it's Vechule or Vegomer. So, I guess we have to see the letter. It's going to take a while. Let's start. Let's do one or two pesukim now. Yedia Levi Lamalkut. We know the king to Yudai the Slichum Milabasach that the Jews who came from you are laying upon us. As to Yushlein Kiyosa, they came to Yushalayim, the city of Mardasa, and they were rebellious. Ubiishta. Banayan, and they built bad stuff. They enhanced the walls. Vushaya yachitu, and the foundations have been founded. Okay, so the Malbim says here. That this is had a double intention. You sent them free. Because they're saying to Koresh, you're the one who sent them here. So that's evidence it's already canceled days of Koresh. After Koresh, then we have to say, that means the people sent from the country. This was the treachery and the forgery which the copiers made. You could say this in two different understandings. It's going on the city. Yerushalayim is a city which is rebellious and sinning. And Binyan is a separate statement. They're building something there. It's a base of Mikdash. Mean that they're really base of Mikdash. And they made the walls of the house. Why? They're ready to put together the foundations. Okay, look, that wouldn't be a lie. Who should have bought Shem as base of Shem? It says Koresh. But you can read it differently. That the they're building the city. The king would have known was falsehood. Loya Magil Amonish would not have been punished because it's ambivalent. Because it could really tolerate both interpretations of the pasuk, and they could also apologize. The Rayush, Shabonim Shom as Beis Hamikdash, that they're building there the Beis Hamikdash. So he says pasuk Gimel. Kan yadir levi l'malko. Now it should be known to the king, the henke v'yosa doch tizbenei, that this city is going to be built up. V'shuraya, and the walls, yishtachlu, will be enhanced. Min denoa v'lo, from the money which you gave them. V'aloch, no, 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 v'aloch are different types of taxes. And they're not going to pay you taxes anymore. And the other tax of the king will be damaged. Okay, so he says, "Pesukim on the Malbim." Can I tell you, if it's going to be rebuilt, Yishlachlu Komosa, and its walls will be enhanced. Me name, me seem these taxes. I crying, b'she minad of luv aloch. Loi new old. They're not going to give anymore. Kim redu melech is going to rebel against the king. But tazika knachnasas amlochim, and the income of the king will be damaged. Or it's more otzer amelech, perhaps the treasury of the king. Okay, I think we're going to stop here for today. I'm not sure where. What's your opinion? I think we do have to go on further in the letter. I might have. I'll check.
Yeah.
Right. Right. Okay, fine. Sure. All right. Have a good week.